maybe the easiest way to put it. Every now and then, you're going to have an issue. It happens. Guess what? Welcome to human life. But if you have it on a regular basis and things start to happen and it's now and then it's again and then it's again, there are other causes involved here. So let's talk about those other causes here that really can shut things down.
Absolutely. This is a multifactorial issue, okay? And these are just some of the list of a very short list, actually, of many different things that can cause erectile dysfunction. Performance anxiety, organic impotence, diabetes, neurologic causes, medicines. And that doesn't mean, or does it give the patient the opportunity to be able to stop the actual medication? Low testosterone lifestyle choices. These are all things that can really affect a person's ability to be able to maintain, to get and or maintain an erection that's rigid enough for the entirety of sexual intercourse. So it's multifactorial.
With medicines. Now you've got to know, and again, the patient has got to be completely honest with you in what the patient is on, what they take, because there are other medications. Isn't that part of the issue too, because there are some people who really don't, still to this day, are not very honest with their doctor. If they're not, you can't properly diagnose it.
That's correct. I use sex health, men's sex health, as a window into their overall health. Because let's face it, if they're having difficulty maintaining or getting an erection, they probably have other medical problems. They may have undiagnosed diabetes, hypertension, which is high blood pressure. And these medications, another great point that I tell guys is, yes, some of these medications do have, as a side effect, erectile dysfunction, but they should not stop that medication. Because if they stop it, guess what? The actual disease process that they're treating will cause erectile dysfunction even worse. It could potentially cause death.